It's the old question, which came first, the chicken or the egg? New Hampshire has the first presidential primary. Most candidates enter it, and the media flood in to report it. Next time, Iowa holds its party caucuses even earlier. The candidates all rush there. The reporters follow, droves of them, and are criticized, especially by the losers, who complain that reporters are identifying them as losers on the basis of early, limited results, and thus make it harder for them to continue in the race.
If you take a look at the Iowa caucus, there were 24 delegates to the convention at stake there, but to date, none of them have been chosen. They're not chosen until the final state primary, or state convention in June. So you had the media placing an inordinate emphasis on the results of the preference poll of 120,000 people in Iowa.
How are you? Nice to see you, ladies.
These early primaries and caucuses are condemned as media events, but it is the candidates and their campaign managers and their publicity men who plan and stage the events and invite reporters and photographers to cover them. George Reedy has worked both sides of this street, both as a political reporter and as news secretary to Lyndon Johnson. Reedy says politicians know the facts of presidential primary life, or they should.
And what happens is that the candidates who can determine the winning strategies are usually the ones who best understand America for the moment, who best understand the political process, and who ultimately will probably make the best candidates.
The Iowa caucus was the first event of this presidential year, but the first primary was still in New Hampshire, where such an army of reporters and photographers descended that Linda Ellerby of NBC News was inspired to make this report.
Those are newspaper reporters being filmed by a television network, being taped by another television network, and counting the camera that's taping this, that makes three cameras and 16 members of the national media in this room, and no politicians.
New Hampshire can make or break a candidate. Since 1952, every man elected president had won his party's primary in New Hampshire.
Well, frankly, as long as we have this kind of a system, I don't know that there's any way around the press having this kind of influence. The only thing that would change that is to change the system somewhat and lessen the number of primaries, put more control back in the hands of some of the party leaders.
Don't forget there is a relationship between the political reporters and the politicians themselves. And usually when the press anoints someone as the candidate, it's because most of the professional politicians have anointed that person as the candidate.
This is what any politician would describe as a fantastic media opportunity. Philadelphia's Italian Market, where Ronald Reagan and George Bush, Rosalind Carter, and Ted Kennedy all made the scene the same week, days before the Pennsylvania primary. There weren't all that many potential voters there, but it's a colorful scene and it makes a nice picture for the evening news shows. It was an event staged by the candidates more for the benefit of the reporters following their campaigns than it was to try to win votes at the market. To point the press in the right direction, most candidates stationed campaign aides on the bus. It is all part of the unique relationship which grows between the press and the candidate who succeeds early and moves on to bigger things, larger states. He draws more coverage, and now wherever he goes, the press bus follows. And as they travel and live and work together in this special world, sometimes they even laugh together.
I've alluded to the fact that I appreciate what he is doing.
You can tell Chris Wallace, he's a good friend. Chris is a friend. You can tell him, he won't tell anyone. Just go ahead and do the right thing, Chip.
Take Mark Levinson, for instance. One of the finest reporters I've ever come across.
I'm on my way, yeah. Right. Just give him the right answer.
Basically, it still comes down to this. Well, the candidate tries to put his best foot forward.
Take the next question.
Your minority support so far.
The press tries to trip him up.
Well, I have President Carter and you, if he's nominated.
That is the way it always has been in this country, and probably the way it should be.
I think Mr. Anderson.
If the polls are correct, all these changes have left about half of our registered voters dissatisfied and asking, is there a better way?